Hi everyone, welcome to the studio vlog for January. Well, almost all of January. I'm going to split this vlog into two parts as I have quite a lot to cover. At the start of January, we went to see the Hilma F. Klint exhibition at the Wellington City Gallery. Hilma F. Klint was a Swedish artist who was born in 1862 and died in 1944. I don't have a lot of clips as the lighting wasn't playing nicely with my phone camera. Sorry about the flickering in some of these clips. I do recommend seeing this exhibition if you're able. There are so many beautiful paintings. Day, the weather was still lovely, so we went for a walk around the waterfront. This yarn bombing art looked like it had only been done fairly recently. It is Monday the 10th of January. It's my first day back streaming today for 2022, so I'm pretty excited. And this morning I also get to use my new planners and plan out some things for the month. So I've got my daily one here, and this is the one that I use for just sort of glancing at during the day to make sure that I'm on time for stuff. So I'll be filling this out a little bit better. I've added times for streams and things so far, but not too much else for this week. And then over here, I think I might have shown this once before, I have my Patreon planner. It's got all of my monthly monthly ideas and projects and things that I'm going to be doing for Patreon in there, plus a few other things like vlog ideas and stuff like that. So I'm going to be going through that this morning and adding a few things to that. I already did a little bit of planning over the weekend, but yeah. Hopefully I can sort out this week a little bit better. Today I'm going to be doing some video editing to start off with. Then I have to make a reel for Instagram for posting for the stream later, and a few other things as well. So I'm going to be doing that. But first of all, yay! Using my new diary for the year. So let's go. Here's a quick update on my opera moth paintings. The underpainting for the rosy maple moths is well underway, and I have added a layer of paint now to just about every area of the painting. I need to do more work on the values and add some extra detail, and then I should be able to start on the colour layers in a week or two. I'm approaching the finishing line with my black morph peppered moth painting. There is still a lot of fine detail to go, but it is looking really good. I'm enjoying adding all of the tiny scales to the wings and the hairs on the legs. Sketchbooks, and I've started with this accordion style sketchbooks in one of my Wednesday crafting streams. This first one is a bit wonky, but I have since made one which is less wonky, so that's great. Please note, this is not a tutorial, as I am just learning myself. I just wanted to try this for fun, but I will show you my process. These accordion sketchbooks are super simple to make. I used a spare piece of chipboard for the covers and cut out long strips of drawing paper. I then folded the paper accordion style. This way, I can have a smaller squarish piece of paper to draw on, or if I unfold several squares, I can create a long panorama. I think this will be super useful for plein air sketching. Then put the sketchbook in the book press for a few hours to get it nice and flat. I decided I wanted to add a ribbon so I could tie the book shut and make it a little more secure. Unfortunately, I only had a very short ribbon, so it didn't work as well as I wanted, but next time I think this method of gluing down a longer ribbon and adding the paper circles to cover the ends will work very well. I'm looking forward to doing a landscape painting, so I will show you how that turns out later on. Okay, I just finished the stream a little while ago, and this is how far I got with the painting. there's still a lot to go, but I had a lot of fun with some masking fluid techniques, and added a little bit of colour when I took some of the masking fluid off up here, but there's still a lot to go. You can see it all over the painting. I've got to add quite a few more layers, and my desk is quite a big mess now as well. So I'm going to clean that up. I've got to make my YouTube video public, which is the vlog for December, and yeah, then I will be doing some more digital art this afternoon. Space in my little purple tray is that my family knows me very well, and I got a few pencil sharpeners for Christmas. I am always on the hunt for a good pencil sharpener, and they are hard to find. One from Daiso gets the thumbs up from me. It is not as sturdy as some of my others, but the dial mechanism that lets you choose how sharp you want the lead to be works really well. Then I did some extra work on the watercolour landscape, although there's still quite a bit to go. On the Friday of that week, we went on a trip to Soames Island, which is a nature reserve with a very interesting history right in the middle of the harbour. I am going to make a separate video on that trip, so if you like birds, dolphins, history and outdoor drawing adventures, look out for the next vlog. Next time, our trip to Soames Island! See you then! Thanks for watching, and have a wonderful day!